Hi, I'm Sad Panda, a new episode of Forget About It, and I'm going to stare into your soul. Lord of the Rings is a sequel to the really famous Lord of the Dance, a movie that I will not try to remember because it makes my brain bleed in agony every time I try to remember something. It's basically a documentary on a walking marathon in New Zealand, populated by the Alliance, the Flight of the Conchords, ships, rocks, and that dude in a suede. I'm not going to summarize the main plot of the movie, since it would be pointless to give all the amazing details of two guys walking from point A to point B. All there is to remember is that there is a ring that can make you younger and that can project you into the future.
That's like a baby's toy.
Now, if you will excuse me, I got something to do in the future. For me, the best and saddest moment is the whole storyline of Gandalf, the Master of Magnet, and his really popular line,
"Welcome to die!"
He would engage Dracula in an epic fight. Then they switch to a dance-off. But Gandalf got served by Dracula and he dies.
Allons-y, allons-y.
And of course, there's a main villain in this movie, better known as Sauron, the evil lighthouse, guarded by a zombie fisherman.
A zombie fisherman? A zombie fisherman? A zombie fisherman?
Except for Gollum being the comic relief, nothing much happened until shit is getting real when some of the marathon participants try to cheat by using spears. The ending was rather disappointing, since Boromir loses the ring and spends an hour looking for it. Yes.
But he probably got it wrong, so forget about it. It was a very enjoyable movie, and it never fails to disappoint. Wait. Panda, you motherfucker!